right, everyone. Welcome to a very special edition of the Ohio Bobcats Coaches Show at Jeff Bowles, March Madness edition. Coach, just take me through what this past week has been like and winning the MAC tournament to get to this moment.
Yeah, thanks, Justin. Such an awesome experience for our guys and our university. I know there's a lot of alumni out there. They're very proud. And to be able to go up to Cleveland and win those three games and cut down the nets, you know, that's why you play the game, March Madness. And here we are.
I know you said that this was the goal when you walked in the door, came back to Athens. And did you think it would happen this soon, though? I mean, it was a combination of guys that you recruited, but also guys that you inherited. Did you think that in year two, this would be the result?
I thought we had the talent to do it. You know, obviously, we're still a pretty young team. And majority of time in leagues like this, you know, seniors and juniors win leagues. Right. And, you know, if you look at, you know, Kent State, you look at Akron, Toledo, BG, you know, Buffalo, very junior, senior dominated teams. And, you know, I think we were playing really well, playing with a lot of confidence. And I think, you know, our guys did a phenomenal job, three games in 3 days.
Just take me through how that went about, because you went from having four games in 36 days to having three games in a row, and not just winning those games, but dominating those games. There was 120 minutes of action. You won for 117 minutes of those. I don't think people quite comprehend how hard that is to do, given the circumstances in which you entered the tournament.
Yeah, it was definitely different. You know, we went on a 21-day pause, then played three games in 5 days, then we had another positive test. Had two games canceled, so we had played three games in 35 days. You know, the first game against Kent State was our fourth one in 36 days. And one of our kids, our starting two guard, came out of a contact trace quarantine and had not practiced in 10 days. And, you know, our guys went out and dominated Kent State, and that set the tone for the tournament.
Just take me through the reaction from the players, because this is every kid's dream, it's every coach's dream, is to get to March Madness and have this opportunity to play for a national championship. What was that moment like with the team, both on the court but also in the locker room after the game?
Yeah, it was, you know, elation. And as you know, I was talking to, you know, Coach Mata the other day, and, you know, been there as a player, was there as assistant coach, and now as a head coach. And when you're a head coach, you know, I wanted these guys to experience what I went through as a player.
Right.
And, you know, there's no better feeling to see your name pop up on that screen on Selection Sunday. And just the euphoria of, you know, final buzzer, guys going crazy, dancing and cutting down the net. And, you know, I tell everyone that the one negative about this whole deal, they couldn't celebrate with their families. You know, we had to, you know, go right back to the hotel. You know, we couldn't go back to campus and see the student body and let them celebrate with our team. And you know, we came right to Indianapolis. But there'll be a time and a place, you know, for that in the future. But just, you know, awesome, you know, seeing our guys. We came over here. We were supposed to take our first COVID test and then quarantine, go to our rooms. Hmm. And we asked them if we could watch the selection show together and then take our test. And they said yes. So we were able to do that, and, you know, that's a memory of a lifetime for those guys, seeing their name pop up. It's a memory of a lifetime. Like BVP said, man, they can't take that down from the banner. Okay? This group, right, this group is going to be connected forever because of this right here.
Before I get to what this week has been like in the preparation for the game you have coming up against Virginia, I just want to go back to what you said was winning the MAC title both as a player and as a coach. How do those two compare, and what feelings do you have being a player that won it in 94 and now a coach that won it at the same school you went to?
Yeah, I mean, any championship, you know, is just, yeah, that's the pinnacle. That's what you play for. And,
right.
And it's hard. Winning's hard. And I think to have our guys experience, you know, this moment and playing in the big dance, you know, playing for March, this is what every kid dreams about growing up, you know, the opportunity to, you know, compete against the best in the country, and you know, here we are.
Just take me through what this week has been. You said testing, guys can't go anywhere. It's basically the bubble edition of college basketball. You guys are playing in Bloomington. So what has this past couple days been like today? How do you prepare for this game when it's not normal at all?
Yeah, it's been different. You know, we came over and, you know, we did our two COVID tests within a 12-hour span. Every kid has their own room. Every team has their own floor in the hotel, and I think there's 15 or 16 teams in our hotel. And they've done a great job, the NCAA, kind of keeping everyone apart. You know, every morning we do a COVID test, and then, you know, they have practice times over in the convention center. They have courts set up in the convention center for everyone to practice. They have makeshift weight rooms over there, you know, to lift. And really all our guys can do, they can go to the meeting room to grab their meals. They can go to the practice court. They can go to the weight room with as a group, and then back to their hotel room. So, you know, there's no walking around. There's no, you can't go outside. So, you know, it's pretty locked down.
Take me through this matchup you have with Virginia. These are two teams that are kind of polar opposites in a way. Ohio is 17th in the country in scoring. Virginia is 6th in the country in not letting people score. They, you know, have 60 points per game that they let opponents get, and you guys average 80 points a game. How do you game plan for a team that is that much different on defense than what you're used to?
Yeah, I mean, their defense is elite. Tony Bennett's one of the best coaches in the country, one of the best people in the country. And I guess, you know, they're the defending national champions, you know, since there was no tournament last year.
Right.
And, you know, I think when you play them, you know, you have to try to create some type of tempo. And that's hard to do. You know, everyone tries to do it going in playing them. But the system that he runs, you know, is very methodical, very calculated, very efficient. And, you know, we have to try to create some offense somehow, some way. And then on our defensive end, they're very patient offensively. You know, they're the slowest tempo team in the country.
Right.
And it's almost like, you know, there's a 30-second shot clock, but really I told our guys it's got to be a 12-second shot clock. You know, when that hits 12 seconds, you know, you got to focus even more. Your antenna's got to go up. Your communication's got to go up, because that last 12 seconds, they're going to be, you know, trying to score.
You spoke about efficiency. Let's talk about Dwight Wilson. This guy is second in the country in field goal percentage. Luckily, you have a guy in Jason Preston who's top 10 in assists. How important is it to get the ball in both of their hands, but also down low to him where he's most effective? That way you can get as many points as possible against a hard Virginia defensive team.
Yeah, he's been a huge, huge key for us all year long. He and Bennett Vandeposs, you know, down low, posting up. They play well together. Two post options for us. But DJ's got an unbelievable touch, you know, to have 70% from the field, you know, just mind-blowing. And, you know, if you look at the run that we had, you know, he didn't play against Akron. He had a knee injury that he suffered in the practice on Sunday before that. And then we played him against Eastern Michigan, and he still wasn't, you know, 100% against Eastern and Buffalo. And then, you know, he got better, and then we had that pause, which probably helped him, you know, just from a – you know, health standpoint, and he had a great tournament for us.
I'd be remiss not to mention the tournament that Jason Preston has had as well, MVP of that game against Buffalo, the whole MAC tournament. What does that say about him that, despite the way that this season went, injuries and had a little bit of rest because of quarantining and all of that, that even despite that, he came back in the MAC tournament and played his best basketball when it mattered the most?
Yeah, if you look at JP's year, you know, he played that MAC tournament like he did in the preseason. Right. Preseason practice in the first start of the year. And he went through that lull where he had his injury, missed four games. You know, obviously didn't practice for a couple weeks. Then he came back and played. And then we had a 21-day pause. Mm-hmm. So he's back to being Jason Preston, and there's no better time of the year to have that for us.
Coach, as you look at the NCAA tournament, how important is it? Obviously, you take it one game at a time based on who you're playing, but knowing that if you do win this Virginia game, you have a hard opponent either way in UC Santa Barbara or in Creighton, whoever wins that game, and trying to get ready for another game and another game as the weeks go on, as you hope that they go on.
Yeah, if you look at the setup, you know, there's a day in between, and we've had two situations where we played back to back to back, you know, the Illinois tournament to start the year and then the MAC tournament to end the year. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we had those three games in 5 days where we went Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. So we've been through, you know, the quick turnaround, you know, scout-wise. But our sole focus is on the 40 minutes with Virginia. Our guys are excited to play. They're loose. You know, they're confident. And it should be a good game.
Well, Coach, I know Bobcat Nation is excited to see you guys play in March Madness. Anything else that you want to add about how this season has gone to get to this moment, and anybody that you want to thank as part of this special team that's one of the first in, 9 years to come back to March Madness?
Yeah, just really proud of our guys for the way they've handled this whole season. And most people don't realize how difficult, you know, it's been, the self-discipline, the sacrifice, you know, and staying away from families, you know, not doing certain things that they've been through. And I think that speaks to the character of the guys we have in our program and how they were raised. And, you know, the leadership we've had, Dr. Nellis, you know, Julie Cromer, you know, our trainer, Tyler Congrove, our strength coach, Jared Azar, our managers for their sacrifice, everything that these people have helped us do, put us in position, has been awesome. And, you know, before I left for the MAC tournament, you know, my wife is like, hey, look, there's a lot of pressure on you right now, because my daughter won a state swim championship with her New Albany high school team. My son, a freshman on the freshman team in New Albany, they won their tournament in Newark. And she said, you can't be the only one. So I felt a lot of pressure leaving that household. And thankfully, we were able to get it done.
Well, I know that Bobcat Nation is very excited to see you guys play this Saturday against Virginia, and very proud of what you guys have done this season. You guys have been a blast to watch all year long. And, Coach, we wish you the best of luck in the NCAA tournament.
All right. Thank you, Justin.
All right, Coach. Take care.